Hello, I'm Martin Janssen and I'm going to tell you something more about De Waag. It's the oldest secular building in Amsterdam and it was originally built as the Anthony's Gate of Amsterdam. As such, it was one of the defense works of the city from, say, about 1500. At that time, this was the end of the city, and the canal over there flat right under the gate building and through on to the seaside of the Ey. In those days, this building stood right into the water and it was much higher as such. You see these towers now stand on the marketplace, but in those days it was water and it was a meter or two lower. So this building rose up much higher as it does today. The front side was different as it is now. Now it's the Ray building, and it has been since say 1619, and then there came a marketplace around it. It was because of the city of Amsterdam extended in those days, so the defense works on these spots weren't necessary anymore. From the time that it was a gate building, you can still see the small shooting holes, even though these are probably not originally anymore, but these old towers were filled with shooting holes and not windows as it is nowadays. That was because of their defense utility. Nowadays it's a Waag and it serves other purposes. But we're going to tell you some more about the time of the gates building and the brickwork on another spot. And as you can see, there's a difference in the combination in the use of brickwork and sandstone in this building. Sandstone is used on all the sides and around the shooting holes, as you can see one of the more original ones over here. The combination of sandstone and brickwork is very common in the Netherlands of those days. Many buildings in Europe were built mainly out of nature stone or other mountain stones and so on. In the Netherlands, we don't have mountains, so there was no sandstone to be found, and or nature stone. So there had to be another solution. All the common houses for the people were built in wood, but the more tough buildings had to be built in stone. The one solution for it was to mold the clay to be found in the soil of the Netherlands and make it into brickwork. Sandstone and nature stone was to be preferred, but it was very expensive. So it was used on the sides and it to be filled up with brickwork. Initially, they molded brickwork in very large stones to make the combination with the sandstone. And later on, they realized that it was too inconvenient to make these large brick stones. So that they entered the other size. And more on, they used less sandstone in the facades of the buildings and made a real serious use of brickwork. But the combination of sandstone and brickwork was for a long time still used as a decorative way of molding your walls. And you can see it in many other buildings still from that time and later on from 1600 and later. They still make use of the combination of brickwork and sandstone in a decorative way. And it was a pity in the Netherlands the sandstone always colored black, and so they often painted the brickwork even more red and the sandstone the initial yellow color. I stand here on the first stone of the building. It mentions in Old Dutch 1488, the 28th day of April, the first stone of this gate was laid. This is also the city side of the gate. This facade overlooks the old city from the time it was still a gate. In old times, this gate building housed also many guilds, and one of them was the Brickworkers Guild. This is the door of this Brickworkers Guild. As you can see in this frame of sandstone, it refers to the Brickworkers Guild by the tools, as depicted on here. And you can see also up in the spire all these master proofs of brickworks around the moldings of the windows. They're very refined cut and pointed out at perspective and shaped in brickwork. Well, there were many guilds housed in this gate in those days. There was one on St. Lucas, the Painters Guild. And as you can see on the next corner, there's one on the Surgeons. I stand here in front of the entrance of the Guild of Surgeons. It's called the Theatricum Anatomicum, the anatomical theater. Inside there was a theater for surgeons to operate on people, whether or not they were hanged men, and people could around watch the surgeon operate on his dead patient. The later theater was added to this building in, say, 1670, I guess. It's a big dome in the center of this building. Well, the surgeons in those days weren't like surgeons in our days. Like, most of them were also barbers, and there was almost one time a separation between surgeons and barbers, that they split up these professions. But the Guild of Surgeons was for a long time, among other guilds, an inhabitant in this building.
Dear.
This ends our walk around the Waag. This remarkable building has served the city of Amsterdam for over 500 years in several ways. I hope you have enjoyed it. Thank you very much.